line segment, line and intersecting lines. Right? Yes. What do you mean by the point? A point determines a location, and we are denoting the point with the single capital letters. Right? Yes. And also we have seen some models for the point. Right? Yes. The next, line segment. A line segment has two ends and it has definite length, and we have denoted the line segment AB as AB line segment. Right? Yes. And similarly, the line. A line segment which extends in both the direction infinitely. So then the line segment is called as a line. A line segment which extends in both the directions, then it is called as a line. Right? Yes. For example, a line can be shown it as with the both side directions. Okay? Yes. Okay? And then next, intersecting line. The two lines which intersect at the common point, then the lines are called as a intersecting lines. For example, I said that the capital letter X and the road crossings and the two edges of a chopping box. In previous class, I have shown that, right? Yes. In this class, we are going to learn about the one of the basic geometrical idea, that is parallel lines. Yes. Look at the table. Here I have drawn one of the table here. The top ABCD is flat, right? Yes. Can you observe here the points, line segments, and intersecting lines? Yes. See here, it is a point A, point B, point C, point D, point H, point E, point F, and point G. Yes. Are you able to identify the line segments here? Yes. Here, AB is a one of the edge of a table, so it has two ends, then it is a line segment. So AB is a line segment, and then BC. BC has two end points, so then it is also a line segment. Then C and D are the two end points. So CD is a line segment. Then AD. So AD is also having two end points. Then it is a line segment. Then see here, CF and BG and DE also, and AH also a line segments. We can observe, we can identify in the given table, right? Yes. Can you able to identify the intersecting lines here? Yes. The two lines which intersect or which passing through with the common point, then the lines are called as a intersecting lines. Yes. See here the two lines, BC is one of the edge and CF is one of the edge, means it is the line segment. So these two line segments are intersect at the common point. As you can see here, BC is a line segment and CF is a line segment. You can observe here, C is a common point. Yes, C is a common point. So it is an intersecting point. BC, the line segment BC and the FC, the common point is here C. Then we can say that BC and CF are the intersecting lines, right? Yes. Similarly, you can also observe here, AD is one of the line segment and ED is also one of the line segment. Yes. AD is one of the line segment and BD is also one of the line segment. You can observe here, D is a common point. Yes, D is a common point. The two lines which intersect at the common point, so then the lines are called as a intersecting lines. Here we can say that AD and DE are the intersecting lines. The intersecting point is here D, right? Yes. Similarly, AD and AB, here ADA and AB. So these two line segments are intersect at the point A, then the two line segments are called as a intersecting lines, right? Yes. Here BC and BG. So these two lines are intersecting at the common point B, Then these two lines are called as a intersecting lines, right? Yes. Can you observe which two line segments then do not meet, means they do not intersect? Observe here AB line segment and DC, or they do not meet. So the two lines are in a plane are said to be parallel. So parallel means between the equal distance. The two lines in between, there is an equal distance. So then the lines, they do not meet each other. So here AB and CD are the parallel lines. For example, I will take here, it is a A point and it is B point, and it is D and it is C. So you can observe here that these are the two lines. I will extend in both the direction. AB and CD are the lines. I extend in both the direction. So you can observe here the distance between the A and D is here 5 cm. In the beginning, the distance between A to D is 5 cm, and the end also the distance between the line AB and CD is 5 cm. Means they do not meet each other at an infinite distance. However, you can extend these two line segments endlessly, so we can get the equal distance from these two lines. So then the lines are called as a parallel lines. So can we say that here E, F, G, H are the parallel lines? No. Why? Because the distance between the lines EF to GH, at the beginning there is a 6 cm. For example, it is a 6 cm distance between the E and G. So at the end there is no the 6 cm distance. So it may be the 4 cm distance. So however, if I extend these two lines at the one point, then we meet each other. At one of the point, these two lines are meet each other. So these are not the parallel lines. The parallel lines means two lines are in a plane. If they are said to be parallel, they do not meet each other at infinite distance. Okay? Yes, then the lines are called as a parallel lines. So models for the parallel lines, the best example is your ruler. So here I have taken one of the ruler. So observe here, it is one of the line, upper line and the lower line. So I can call it as a AB line and a CD line. So you can extend these two line segments endlessly in both the direction, but at the end, so here the distance between these two lines is, for example, it is 3 cm. So at the end also you can measure it, the distance between these two lines is also a 3 cm. Means that these two lines are not intersect at any point in an infinite distance. So then the lines are called as a parallel lines. And also you can observe that the cross bars of a window. So have you seen that? So the cross bars of a window, so those are parallel to each other. The distance between the two cross bars is also same from the beginning and also till the end, right? And also you can observe the ladder. The distance between the ladder, the edges, that is also same. So we can give an example for the parallel lines, that is railway track, that is the railway lines. We can give an example, that is railway lines. We have seen that the distance between the two lines is equal. Means at the end, how much distance is there? Till the end, there will be same distance. So these two lines cannot meet each other. In the picture, in the table also, we can observe that there are parallel lines. Can you observe that? Yes. Here, AB and CD are the parallel lines. Why? Because the distance between these two parallel lines is same at the infinite end. And also these two lines cannot meet each other. Right? Yes, these two lines are the parallel lines. So we can show the parallel lines. So AB line is parallel to parallel. So we have to show by the symbol double one. That is parallel to CD. AB line is parallel to line CD. And also the other two parallel lines we can see here. BE is parallel to EF. Yes, BE is parallel to CF. BE is parallel to CF. And also we can observe that AH is parallel to BG. Can you say that? Yes, AH is parallel to BG. So it is about the parallel lines. Okay, yes, let's go to the one of the basic geometrical idea, that is ray. The next concept is ray. Yes. A ray is a portion of a line and also a line segment. A line segment which extends only in one direction endlessly, then it is called as a ray. Here, EF is a line segment which extends only in one direction. Which extends only in one direction, then it is called as a ray. And now it extends, the point is starting point. Starting point. So it started to extend in one direction, then it is called as a ray. So here EF is a ray, so we can say that EF. So in the upside we have to show with the single arrow, right? So here EF is a ray, we have to show with a single arrow mark. And we can see that the rays, the sun rays. So we can see the sun rays. So it is the starting point, it extends in one direction endlessly, right? So here it is the starting point, it extends in one direction. So then it is called as a ray. It is the rays of sun, so we can call it as a sun rays, right? And also we can observe the torch. So when we switch on the torch, we can observe the rays of light, right? And also we can see the rays of a light also, right? Yes. So these are the examples for rays. So these are the examples, we can see the rays, right? So here light. Ray is a portion of a line, and also we can say that a line segment which extends only in one direction, then it is called as a ray. So we can, the starting point is here E, so it extends in only the single direction. So EF is a ray, we have to show with a single arrow mark. Okay, so here I will draw one of the angle here. A, B, C. Okay, like this. Name the rays in this picture. Yes, we can observe here. Here B is a point, and here A, and here also B, and here C. So these two lines are intersecting lines. It will intersect at the point B. And here it is the starting point. It extends only in the one direction. And here B is the starting point, and it extends only in the one direction. So here B is the starting point, here A is the ray point. That is BA is a ray, and also BC is also a ray. A line segment which extends only in one direction, then it is called as a ray. Okay, here BA is a ray and BC is also a one of the ray with the starting point B. With a single point, so if I put the single point, so we can draw infinite number of rays from a single point. Here it is a single point, we can draw number of rays from this point, right? So like this, we can draw n number of rays from a single point. Then the next we are going to solve the exercise 4.1. Let's solve the exercise 4.1. Yes, in the first question is use the figure to name. So here they are given one of the figure. Then here they are given some of the points. That is 4 points. That is first one 5 points. We have to name here from the using this figure. Then a line and 4 rays and 5 line segments. Okay. So here we know that the points. So here how many points are there in this given figure? Yes, we can point here. Here there is a point B, point C, point O, point E, point D. Right? Yes. How many points are there here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 points. And name here is point. Here, first one, point B, come on, point C, sorry, point O, come on, point C, come on, point E, come on, point D. So these are the 5 points we can. These are the 5 points. Okay. The next one is a line. Yes. We know that the lines means the line segment which extends in both the direction. You see here it extends in one direction and finally it is extends in the other direction. So we can say that DB or BD is the one of the line. So it is a single line. So in the given picture, okay. So DB is a line. So we can write DB is a line. Is a line which extends in the both direction. So we have to show BD in the upside. We have to keep the double arrows. Or we can also read it as DB. DB is a line. This double arrow says the DB is a line, means which extends in the both direction. Then similarly, 4 rays. Yes, here a line segment which extends only in one direction. Here O is a starting point, so it is extends in one direction. So we can say that OD is a ray, and also OE is a ray, and OC is a ray, means it extends only in one direction. And OB is a starting point, it extends in one direction. Yes, how many rays are there here? First one OD ray, then OB ray, then OC ray, and OB ray. So here also there is a ray, but here there is no point, so we cannot count it. Okay? Yes. Right here. 4 rays are, first one OB ray. So OB right upon the single arrow. It says that OB is a ray. Then next OC is a ray. OC is a ray. Then OE. OE is a ray. And OD is a ray. OD is a ray. Okay. Then finally the fourth one is 5 line segments. A line segment. 5 line segments. Yes. A line segment, we know that line segment has 2 end points. Yes, we can say that DE is a line segment because DE has 2 end points and OE has 2 end points. It is also one of the line segment. Then OC is a line segment. Then OB is a line segment. And also we can say that, so except this E, OD is also one of the line segment. Right? Yes, we can write the line segments here. First write here, OB is a line segment. Yes. OB is a line segment. It has 2 end points. So we have to keep the single bar. Okay? Then next, OB after OC is a line segment. Just consider here, don't extend here. So after here, it has 2 end points. Then this OC line segment. Come on. Then next, OE. So OE is a line segment. Then next, close here. OD is a line segment. OD is a line segment. Then next, close here. To here, DE is a one of the line segment. And DEE is the one of the line segment. So is it clear? So how to write the given points, line, rays and segment using the given pictures, right? Yes. So we'll solve the second question in the next class, right? Thank you.